the Lord Jesus Christ, of the communion of the Holy Spirit, be with you all.
Amen.
Dear friends, today we celebrate the Christmas, a great celebration. God loved the world so much. He gave His only Son. We have lovely children today of our parish. Into the gospel passage we have the narrated words, the pattern of the Christmas Eve. So on behalf of parish and loving children, the family, friends, and all the visitors of the parish, together we celebrate this great mystery. Emmanuel, God is with us. For the times we failed, we ask for God's pardon and mercy. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us and forgive us our sins. Bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated. a reading from the prophet Isaiah. For Zion's sake, I will not be silent. For Jerusalem's sake, I will not be quiet, until her vindication shines forth like the dawn, and her victory like a burning torch. Nations shall behold your vindication, and all the kings your glory. You shall be called by a new name, pronounced by the mouth of the Lord. You shall be a glorious crown in the hand of the Lord, a royal diadem held by your God. No more shall people call you forsaken, or your land desolate. But you shall be called my delight, and your land is found. For the Lord delights in you and makes your land his spouse. As a young man marries a virgin, your builder shall marry you. And as a bridegroom rejoices in his bride, so shall your God rejoice in you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Then he removed Saul and raised up David as king, of him he testified, I have found David, son of Jesse, a man after my own heart. He will carry out my every wish. From this man's descendants, God, according to his promise, has brought to Israel a Savior, Jesus. John heralded his coming by proclaiming a baptism of repentance to all the people of Israel. And as John was completing his course, he would say, what do you suppose I am? I am not he. Behold, one is coming after me. I am not worthy to unfasten the sandals of his feet. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. us. So they hurried up and found Mary and Joseph, who saw the baby was lying in the manger.
Thank you. Good job.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord, Be done to me according to your word. Second, discernment. Joseph and John the Baptist discern. What does it mean to discern? Discern means walk in the path of the Lord. In spite of all these distractions, commercial Christmas, we say, we keep Christmas in the crib, Christ in my life, and Christ in the Christmas. And all the more than keeping Christ, it is a contemplation. And finally, we all take a Christian journey. Journey is not from point A to point B, but this journey is towards the salvation of God. God gives a beautiful gift. He gave his only son to make eternal life. Once in upcountry New York, a lady was going for shopping in a beautiful shopping area. It was snowing a bit, thank God, not snowing in the cold weather. But snowing there, a little boy was peeping at the shoe store and didn't have a shoe on his left toes. The lady looked at him, he looked at the store, she took him along to the store and said, one of the cashier, can you get me a bucket of warm water and a cloth and a pair of socks? Took the boy to the back of the store and then washed his feet and put a nice socks on his feet and said, pick up the shoe you want. And the boy picked up the shoe, and this lady put the shoes on him. She asked him, how do you feel? He says, I feel comfortable and I'm very happy. And immediately, the lady told the cashier to pack up some extra pairs of socks for him. And as she was leaving the store, the boy held the hand of the lady and said, who are you? Are you a friend of God? Are you a friend of God? Christmas is to keep Christmas and Christ. It's more of God's love for us. It is contemplation. It's a connection. It's Christ. Like Mary, we are called to listen. Like John the Baptist and Joseph, called to discern, like the Magi who got the gift, we are to journey and to move forward. God so loved the world, he gave his only son, Emmanuel. God is with us. As we have this race of faith, as we have despite the faith, and in a meeting place, he became man, just and bow on behalf of all of us. Let's profess something. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial of the Father.
As the light of the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
for leaders of nations, states, and cities, that they show the compassion of God in their dealings with one another. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For children, that they listen to Jesus and follow his example. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Holy Land, that it may truly know the peace given by Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our servicemen and women, serving in all parts of the world, first responders, police, firefighters, and medical personnel, that they may enjoy God's protection and blessing at Christmas. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all gathered here around Christ in this holy place, that the mystery of Christmas lead us to a greater love of God and neighbor, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, hospitalized, and homebound of our community, and for all those written in our parish intention book, that their hearts be filled with peace and hope, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died in the hope of the resurrection, especially the deceased of Saints Peter and Paul the Apostle, as well as the living members, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In silent prayer, let us offer God the needs of our hearts. We pray to the Lord. Sending us your Son. This is your prayer to keep us faithful to the baptism and promises. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
Spirit. May we serve you all the more eagerly for knowing that in them you make manifest the beginnings of redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, a duty and a salvation. For this and every day to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. From the feast of this hope-filled mystery, who invisible in his own divine nature, is appeared visibly in ours and begun before all ages, is begun to exist in time, but raising up himself all that is cast down. He might restore unity to all creations, call strange humanity back to heavenly kingdom. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration, we sing.
as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray from every evil, with gracious and glorious grace, and the base of the count of your mercy. And may your gifts be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait for blessed hope in the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of Jesus is now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who stood your pastor's peace, and the will my peace I give you. Look at and sense the faith of the church. Gracious one, peace and unity, cause of your will. Live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let's have each other a sign of peace.
you stand up? They are the ones who are
looking at
them. Thank you, and I thank all of our budding young stars. We wish you all a very Merry Christmas on behalf of all of our staff members, priests of the parish, the entire priests who are with us. We extend our very best wishes for a Merry Christmas on this Christmas Eve, tomorrow as well, and Christmas Day if you're traveling or journeying to be with friends or family. We hope you have a safe journey and that all the blessings of Christmas joy will be yours. God bless you and thank you.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, be great that we may draw new vigor from celebrating the nativity of your only begotten Son, by whose heavenly mystery we receive both food and drink, who lives and waits forever and ever. Amen.